Hi there. In the last class, we have seen credit ratings. However, the ratings published by rating agencies are only available for large companies whose bonds are traded on the market. Many small and medium enterprises are therefore not rated. What happens in those cases? The solution is represented by internal ratings.
The internal rating-based approach of Basel II and III allows banks to use internal methods to determine the probability of default of a counterparty. Therefore, most banks have their own procedures to assess the creditworthiness of their corporate and retail clients, especially when external credit ratings are not available. Internal rating approaches mostly rely on profitability and balance sheet ratios. A bank, as every other company, is interested in the capability of its counterparty to service its debts. It is clear that the liquidity of each client is extremely important. In fact, in repaying a debt, cash is more important than profits. Liquidity is the most important thing. The prototype of internal rating methods is represented by Altman's Z-score. Introduced in 1968, the Z-score is a financial distress index, extremely important in fundamental analysis. It is obtained using discriminant analysis, a well-known tool in statistics. There are different versions of Altman Z-score, depending on the type of company or client under scrutiny: large company, small company, manufacturing company, and so on. The typical time horizon is 1 year. This means that the Z-score gives us information about the possibility that our counterparty will go bankrupt within 1 year. Let's consider an example. For publicly traded manufacturing companies, the Z-score is obtained with the present equation. As you can see, this equation contains some numerical values, which are used to multiply some ratios, such as working capital to total assets and sales to total assets. By plugging in the values of the balance sheet ratio, we get a number, the Z-score. This number must be compared with some specific thresholds, which are obtained by analyzing historical data about the financial distress and the default of companies. These thresholds depend on the type of Z-score you use. For the example we have just considered, the thresholds are as follows. If the Z-score is smaller than 1.8, a company is very likely to default in the near future. If the value is larger than 3, default is extremely unlikely within 1 year, and even more. If the Z-score is between 1.8 and 2.7, default is definitely possible. Between 2.7 and 3, some more attention is needed. Further analysis may be necessary. Sometimes this is called the gray area. The accuracy of the Z-score in this area reaches a minimum. However, on average, Z-scores attain an accuracy of 80-90%. Let's consider a very quick exercise. From the balance sheet, we can compute the following ratios for a corporate client. Is this client likely to default in the near future? Plugging in the ratios in the formula, we can say no, our client is in a safe position for the moment. To summarize, banks use their own formulas and proprietary tools. However, most of these are just modifications of Altman Z-score, or they are obtained using similar techniques. Naturally, banks may also use instruments they can buy from external providers and use them as internal tools. As we can expect, similar methods are also used by rating agencies to assign a rating to bonds, especially when they first appear on the market.
Now, assume that your counterparty defaults and goes bankrupt. Do you lose all the money, all the credits? The answer is typically no. At least, we hope.
The recovery rate is the amount of credit recovered through foreclosure or bankruptcy procedures in event of a default, expressed as a percentage of face value. This is the definition. For a bond, it is typically the price at which it trades about 30 days after default, as a percent of the face value. The average recovery rate for bonds is around 35-40%. For loans and mortgages with first lien on assets, it is usually around 65%. Recovery rates are negatively correlated with default rates on the market. This means that during a crisis, when many companies and individuals go bankrupt, recovery rates dramatically decrease. Could you say why?
Okay, see you soon. Alla prossima, as we say in Italian. Bye!